Don't wanna rush out, can help you if you're homeless. Let me touch it from wrong, girl, tell me. Cause I get caught up in the life I live in hell. See, I never thought I'd see the day when I'm a part of that. You ain't heard, I've been on the clown and get around. That's my world, see you walking if you're looking good. Yes, indeed, I'm a body like a sex
team. What's going on, everybody? I got a frog in my throat, didn't I? Excuse me, I got a little cold, a little summer cold. Ain't y'all got one of them? Know what it is, it's heat, I guess. But I've been hanging out there watching the damn TTC videos there. I come across... Man, that's classic right there, shit. I come across a damn video... This new little old rookie, his name's A.C. Carter, I think that's his name, or some shit like that. Called out a veteran. Called out Herschel Talker. The king of the keyboard type of ninjas. Who ain't got the stroke no more to get up here and cam up for his team. Because he knows they're going to suck again this year. You know, you Georgia fans... Y'all make me fucking sick. Y'all got up here first year. Y'all's holding that flag up high, baby. We're gonna win the East. We're gonna win the East. Didn't do shit. Got your ass whooped by about everybody. Tennessee beat that ass. Next year, last year, you go 6-6. 6-6, y'all motherfuckers start dropping like flies. No, Mr. Big Dog. One of the best video makers on here. No, Mr. Big Dog. No, Herschel Talker. One of the smart-ass motherfuckers on here. One of the smartest people in America. Herschel Talker. Hell, go ask him. He'll tell you. You got no more Georgia videos from Ghost. You got Magnum up here trying to fight Ghost. And he's talking a little bit. He says he's got the Boise State video coming, people. Look out. Look out. Firstly, I don't know if Georgia's going to pull that game out. But I hate Boise State, so I kind of hope they do. You know, if it wouldn't have been for Oklahoma... Getting beat on a high school football play in the Fiesta Bowl, no one would ever know about Boise State. Believe me, people, no one would care. So, tip my hat to Owen Kono. Thank you, Sooners, for that one. For putting them in the mix. But now they're going to come on down to Georgia Dome and they're playing the Georgia Bulldogs. Georgia Bulldogs bringing back some great players, but lost a lot in the backfield. Lost Caleb King, lost the Ely kid. Shit ain't looking good over there, people. They've had to bring a linebacker to the offensive side of the football. That's never good, but it worked out for them back in the 90s when they put Robert Edwards over there. So, who knows? Hell, shit might work out for them. I don't think it will. But come on, Herschel Talker, where you been, brother? You can't get up here. All you can do is sit over on keyboard and talk your little bullshit. Talk your same old shit, old law of all and all this bullshit. Man, that's so 2009. You know, and I hear old Bill over there, and he talking about loyalty and all this shit. Man, you don't talk about hard times, Bill. You don't talk about hard times. Let me tell you something about hard times, man. Try going 3-8 after coming off an SEC championship the year before and see how that puts a little down. Woo! A little hard in your times there, boy. Shit. Alabama fans, we've been through fucking the 90s, half the fucking 2000s before we got our fucking shit together. So y'all don't know nothing about fucking hard times. You think we was baking fucking cookies when we was going 6-6 and on probation and switching coaches every fucking semester? No, we wasn't. I didn't like it a fucking bit. As an Alabama fan, but let me tell you something. I didn't jump off my fucking team and go nowhere else. And you think I was a fucking Tennessee fan because they quit putting on third down. Well, you stupid motherfuckers, quit believing everything you see on fucking videos. You know, y'all learn that shit from Tide Boy and fucking the Big Gravy. Big Gravy up here for 2 fucking years, claiming Bama, then ups and fucking and joins the fucking Corn Dog Nation over there. And you think that I was a Tennessee fan, and I quit being a Tennessee fan because they punted on third down. Hell, that's like me stopping being a fucking Braves fan for them batting a goddamn pitcher 8th or some shit. It don't make no sense. It don't make no sense. It's not true. It's a fucking work. But as far as being a true fan, there is nobody more truer than this motherfucker right here. I promise you that, boy. And if you got a problem with that, you must have a personal problem with me. And we can meet each other halfway and handle it, boy, if you got a fucking real problem with it. I'll show you who the real man is, you little sissy, sitting over there in your mama's underwear. Don't fucking get up here. I know that's why you sitting in the dark. You sitting over there cross-dressing. I know that's why you doing it. Hell, you like old Auburn Runs Edge. You sitting over there in the dark in your mama's underwear, talking shit, claiming, oh, Tennessee, we got so much coming back. Oh, who's going to fix that defense? Hell, y'all can't play 13 players out there. Who's going to fix that motherfucker? You think that defense is going to be able to stop us this year? We're going one for the thumb, boys. That's 5 in a row. Now, BVD, don't you leave me. Damn it. Just cause the motherfucker puts his thumb up there. Don't mean I'm hitchhiking back to fucking Tennessee. So we might have to talk about the travel arrangements. And lay down some ground rules, BVD. So let's get on here and let's talk a little bit about some Alabama football. We lost one of our receivers, Hanks, for 2 games for something to do with practice. I don't know. Hell, he's a 5th-year fucking senior. You ought to be used to puking in that fucking bucket, son. Straighten your ass up. We need you out there. We're going to miss you in the Penn State game, but I think one of these freshmen might step up and surprise some people. I do believe we got some good freshman receivers out there. I've seen a couple of them out there, and we also got Chris Carter's son transferred in from junior college, and the boy can play football. And also like that white kid out of Texas, man. He's something else. You know, gets to the ball well, runs great routes. And, you know, that's a sign of a good young receiver right there. People can run their good routes the way they do. And we got some of the best route runners in the country, people. So I'm not worried about everybody talking about, you don't got Julio Jones, you don't got this, you don't got that. Well, you know, just wait and see, boys, because when y'all see Alabama on TV, y'all going to be like, oh, my God. They look like an NFL football team out there. Because that's exactly what I said when I went to the A game this year. I was like, good Lord, I think we could probably contend in the fucking in the NFC West out there. Them weak-ass teams. But I'm excited about them. want to give a big shout-out to Prince Wembley for sending me this. Thank you, buddy. I appreciate you appreciate you sending me that. I got that in the mail yesterday. Bama Tony talked about it in his video yesterday, but it was an autographed picture that he had sent me, and man, it was like Christmas. And he also sent me an autographed picture of Mark Ingram. It's certified and everything. He does run a memorabilia store down there in Birmingham, Alabama. So you know, shout outs to you. Thank you for sending me that picture. You know, hopefully I can get down there to your store, you know, one day. Hopefully we can go down there and check your store out. Seems like you got some nice stuff down there. I'll check it out. But, you know, I'm excited about this fucking season coming up. It can't get here no sooner. What are we at, 28, 29 days? It's on and popping, boys. Y'all need to get your asses up here and start repping your team. Come on, Georgia Bulldogs, where you at? Where you at, Georgia? Come on. Don't be scared, boys. Come on, One Way Rock. Get up here and rep them down Mississippi State Bull Puppies. I know they're going to be good this year. You might as well just get up here and rep them because, you know, that happens once in a lifetime for your Mississippi State fan. I know it's hard for you, brother, but you need to get up here and rep them this year because they're going to be damn good. I do believe. I think they're going to be a dark horse. But, you know, I'm excited about it. Just wanted to jump on here and actually just show my pictures off. I do have a bet coming for BVD. I'm not ready to put that bet out there yet. I'm going to let him stew about it there a little bit. Think about it. Shout outs to Catadog. Thanks for the video last night, brother, for the WDF wanting to be the top villain. But, you know, I have to get the top villain to straight Chuck. Nobody trolls like the Chuckster. So, but I put you right in there. You, Chuck, and probably the Ghost as being the three best there. You know, WDF villains. So, you know, I talked to the damn president out there. Shout outs to Timmy Turner, but it's all up to him. I can't vote you in there. But that would be my vote. I'm a little biased. Straight Chuck's a good buddy of mine on here. But, you know, been thinking about these Penn State boys, been reading up on them a little bit. Looks like their defense has gotten a little better. They got some stars come back. I just hope they beat their beans and taters because they looked real small out there last year, people. They looked small out there. We make a lot of teams look real small out there. I ain't going to lie to you. Y'all see that when y'all see us on the field when we play Kent State first game of the year. Y'all going to be like, good Lord, look how these motherfuckers eat their beans and taters, boys. It's amazing. It's just amazing at the talent that we got on the field. But, you know, it's got to come together, baby. It's got to come together. And what I hear is Coach Saban's going to play two quarterback system. And I don't see why not. We got two capable quarterbacks that can run our offense. And one of the best running backs in the country. In my eyes, the best. And excited about it. Can't wait till it gets started. So with that being said, there's only one thing for me to say from down here, baby. Come on, TTC, say it with me. And that's Roll Tide Roll. One time up in this bitch, baby. Woo! And oh yeah, Buffalo Heroes. I found your new mascot. If y'all don't know, Penn State got a new mascot coming next year. Check it out. Peace, everybody. One love.